This is B-Nut, and this is going to be an instructional video on applying decals. Many people have asked me to give them instructions or pointers, and so I want to take this time to do a video and just showing you how I do it. There's many ways to do this, but I've done thousands of these figures, and over time I've learned some ins and outs that may be helpful to people that are just starting out. So the first thing I'd like to do is just kind of go over the things that you're going to need. So maybe you can go to the store and get them if you don't have them. Get all this together before you start. You're going to need a regular pair of scissors and also a small pair of scissors. This is used to cut around some of the smaller decals. You need a good pair of tweezers, and I use a couple of small brushes, one with thicker bristles here and the other one kind of medium size. And you're going to need some type of coating, a gloss coating. I use Delta Clear Gloss Glaze, and there's a link to this on my website, bnut.com. If you want to go there, I think you can get this at Amazon, and this is just a smaller container of that. And you're also going to need some Salvaset. You can also find this on Amazon.com. And this is just a smaller container filled with Salvaset. And I use a styrofoam plate with a saturated sponge. You're going to use this sponge quite a bit when applying the decals. You'll cut out the decals and you'll lay them here on the sponge. It's a lot easier than putting the decals in the water. And I have a couple of bottle caps. One bottle cap is filled with water, and the other one will just be used, it's an empty bottle cap, will be used later. And over here, I had 22 Indianapolis Colts that we're going to be doing. These I've already painted, so we're going to start the process from there. These have been painted from head to toe and are ready for decals. The only thing that we don't paint is the socks. I usually wait and do the socks after we apply the decals, and I'll show you why a little bit later. But we have 22 Indianapolis Colts that we're going to fully decal. I'm not going to show every little figure being done, but we're going to go through some of the steps here. First thing we're going to do is just take one of these and we're going to apply the gloss glaze. Now, I apply the glaze before we start decaling the figures, and this helps it does two things. It protects the paint when you're putting on the decals, because sometimes a Salvaset is kind of hard on the paint. So it protects the paint that you got, and also it allows the decals to go on a little bit better, and they don't slide around as much, and it's just a better application. The first thing we're going to do is just pour a little bit of gloss glaze into a bottle cap, the empty bottle cap. We're going to take the one with the thicker bristles here, and we're going to use that brush. Usually just start from head to toe and just brush on the gloss glaze. Just be careful not to glob any of it, allow any globs, you know, around the figure, just kind of smooth it out. And you just go from head to toe. Just get a good even coating on the figure. Okay, we've got one done, and I'm gonna go ahead and do all 22, but I'm not gonna show it on the video, but all 22 will be done exactly like this. And now we're gonna let these dry for 2 to 3 hours. And then after that, we'll be able to apply the decals. So make sure you let this dry and you should be good to go. And the next step will be applying the decals. Okay, now we're gonna start the process of decaling our 22 Colts. And what I normally do is start at the helmet and start from there and work my way down. And I do it in an assembly line fashion. If the team has helmet stripes, I'm gonna do those first. So we're gonna start with the Colts helmet stripes. And I take my plate of decals here. And what I normally do, well, first you have to find out if your decals are pre-cut or not. And if they're pre-cut, this is the part that goes a lot faster than non-pre-cuts. What I normally do on the stripes is I'll cut lengthwise over the top and bottom stripe all the way across the page. Now this sheet of decals has three lines of stripes. So what we're going to do for these to make it even faster is we're going to cut crossways for all three stripes, as you can see here. Now, many people have asked, how do I know how far to cut on these stripes? Well, you'll just learn through trial and error. So what we're going to do first is going to try these three. I cut them a certain length, and we're going to try those three on the figure first. This is filled with Solvacet here, and this bottle cap is filled with water. We'll take our brush with the small bristles here and our tweezers, and we'll just do one figure at a time. And what I normally do is put just a dab of water on the figure, top of the helmet, then take the decals with all three stripes and just slide one off at a time, like this. Place on the helmet, and since you've got water on there first, they move around a lot better. And you can see this one was cut out just perfectly. I've done so many of these, most of the times I get it right on the length. And you just make sure it's straight on the figure. Looks pretty straight. And then what I do is put a dab of Solvacet on the figure. And that one's done. Go to the next one. A dab of water on the helmet. Slide the stripe off. Make sure it's on there correctly. All right, when you get it in place, just put a dab of Solvacet on the figure, and there's the second one. I'll do the rest of these off camera, but you can see how that goes. We're going to do all the helmet stripes, and then I'll come back and we'll start in on the helmet emblems. Okay, now we have a plate full of Colts with the helmet stripes done, and we're going to apply the helmet logos now. We'll take the sheet of decals, and we'll use the regular pair of scissors, and we'll cut lengthwise across the sheet, top and bottom of the row of helmet logos. Now, if they're pre-cut, you can just cut around three or four of them at a time, like I'm going to do here. You see about every four. Just kind of trim around those. And the reason we have the styrofoam plate is all the trimmings will fall on the plate, so you can kind of keep everything clean. And I just place all these on the sponge. You can leave them on the sponge all day long if you need to. That's the advantage of just laying them there. And it only takes a few seconds for the decals to be ready to slide off the backing paper. So I'm just going to put a few on the styrofoam plate on the sponge here. We're just going to decal a few of them here. Dip the brush in the water. You usually put a dab on both sides of the helmet. Take the decals here, slide them off with your thumb. Slide them on the figure, get it adjusted correctly, as you can see there. Do the other side. Get it the way you want it.
Then just put a dab of Solisat. Figure there like that. And that one's good. Sometimes they'll slide, as you see that one slid a little bit. And all you need to do is just slide it back in the right position. You can see there. Do the next figure. Dab water on both sides. See there, it's positioned right on the helmet. You can slide it around since you're using the water to begin with. Get it the way you want it, like that. Put the dab of Solisat on both sides. Just kind of watch, make sure it doesn't slide around. And that one's good to go. Into the next figure. And we'll just show this one and we'll stop. And you just have an assembly line is the way I like to do it. Everybody's different. You can do it one figure at a time if you want. See how that one goes in position there. This is where the pre-cuts save so much time, is on non-pre-cuts you have to slide out the, you would have to cut around each individual decal, and you can see how fast this is going without having to do that. Seam both sides and put a dab of Solisat. Alright, and that one's good to go. So we finished those three, and I'm going to go ahead and do the rest off camera. And we'll come back and we'll tackle the shoulder numbers or names. Shoulder numbers, names, and shoulder stripes. We'll do that next. Okay, now as you can see, we finished the helmets for the Colts. We've done all the helmet stripes and the logos. And the reason you start from the top and work your way down in the decals is so that you can handle the figures without messing up the decals. We can still pick up the figures and do what you need to do and not worry about messing up the decals. So we start from helmet and go work our way down. Now the next thing I do is after we do the helmets, when you work your way down, the next thing we'll do is the player names. And we do a little bit of planning up front to make it easier, make it more like an assembly line type deal. And as you can see here, I've made a spreadsheet with all 22 players, and it's in order of the player number. It goes from smallest to largest on the jersey number, as you can see there. And we're just going to lay the figures out according to this spreadsheet, and we're going to put them here on the table according to the jersey number. We'll start with the smallest one first. We'll just lay them here. This way you'll be able to work a little bit easier and not get confused about what number goes where. And they'll all be laid out in front of you. So we're looking at the spreadsheet, going by the skin color and the number. Work your way down. This is going to help you keep everything straight when you start putting the numbers and the names on. Towards the bottom, make sure I got it right. place here. We have all 22 figures laid out according to jersey number from smallest to largest. Okay, then we're going to take our decals with the player names. Do like we did before, take a regular pair of scissors, cut on both sides of the names all the way down the sheet of decals. Be careful not to cut into the names. Especially hard with white names, they're harder to see, so you need to really be under a lamp. And then you take your smaller pair of scissors, and this is where we're going to cut in between the names. We're going to lay these on the sponge. Now this, I've already got these printed in order that's on the spreadsheet, but when you order decals, your names will probably come in alphabetic order, so you're going to have to sort these names out. Put them on the sponge. Have to get the lighting just right sometimes to see exactly where you're cutting. Just have to be careful not to cut into the names. Cut between the names. All right. Have to let the light hit it just right so you can see. Going to be 22 names here for our team of Colts. Get near the end here. The player names are not going to be pre-cut, so you have to trim around each name. All right. That's why it's good to cut across the page with a regular pair of scissors first. And this makes this a lot easier. These are in order according to jersey number. So now, since we got these in order, we're ready to start decaling right when we have them on the sponge. All right, so we got all those set. And now we're gonna start decaling. We'll take our Salva set and our brush and tweezers, just do like we did before. And just start your assembly line work. I put a dab of water where the player name goes. Use water first, that way you can move the decal around. Just place it on the figure. You will slide it around. Then put a dab of Salva Set on it. And there's your player name. We'll do two or three. Water first, and on the back there. on there straight. Dab a Solvacet. Do one more. And then I'll finish the rest of the names off camera. And then we'll work our way to the shoulder stripes and the shoulder numbers, or sleeve numbers. There's the next name. Do a little dab of Solvacet. When you put the Solvacet, you just got to make sure that it doesn't move after you do it. If it stays on there, if you notice it's on there straight, it should stay that way. But sometimes they'll move around a little bit. I say, okay, I'm going to do the rest of them off camera, and we'll come back and tackle the shoulder and sleeves. Okay, we got the player names on all the figures now. And now we're going to do the sleeve decals. We got two things that go on the sleeve. We have, for the Colts, we have these crescent double lines that go on. And then shoulder numbers. These are the old school Colts, so the shoulder numbers will go on the sleeves. So what we're going to do is we're going to tackle these lines, these double lines that go on the sleeves first, and leave enough room for the numbers. These are pre-cut decals, so you can see the lines here. We're just going to cut off, since they're pre-cut, we're just going to cut off each column here. All right, to let them set a few seconds on the sponge. And each figure, as you're probably aware, is a little bit different on how you put the, how you have to allow room. Some of the figures, there's more room on the sleeves than others. We'll do one of each figure. This is the linebacker QB figure. What we do is water on it first, like we've done all the others. Then the double lines will slide off. Should be able to move them around pretty easily. And what you do on this is just make sure they're kind of straight. Allow enough room for the sleeve numbers. And you have to miss the player name. That's why we put the name on first, so you can kind of tell where these double lines are going to have to go. And you can see how the decal sometimes doesn't sit real well. So that's what the Solvacet is for. You just saturate it there with the Solvacet and you let it dry, and just in a little while it should lay perfectly on the figure. If it doesn't, you may have to put another application of Solvacet on it. And we'll do the other side. See how we're kind of moving it around. Lay it as closely as possible to the figure as you can using the water, and then you apply a Solvacet. And we're just going to let that dry. It's going to take some time, but it should set into the figure. Okay, we'll do one of the guards next. You may have to do a little trimming on the guards, since there's each figure is a little different. What I normally do is, for something like this, I'll cut off a little bit of the decal. You don't need it for it to be as long. You see them maybe cutting off just a small portion. As you can see there, you don't need it to be as long. There's not enough room on the figure for that on these guards. And you'll slide the main portion off. And you apply the water. And it fits right up on the sleeve, just like the others. You can see it goes on pretty good there. And we'll put the Solvacet on that. Use a lot of Solvacet, just saturate it on there. And that's what it looks like. And we'll do the same thing for the other side. We're going to cut a little, while it's still on the backing paper, it's the easiest. Cut it just a little bit off. Since each figure is a little different in shape, cut a little bit of the ends off.
Normally you don't have to do this, but this one type figure on the guards, I found just through experience, it's probably good to cut a little bit off. And you can see how that goes on. We're going to saturate it with the Solvacet. And you notice how we left enough room for the sleeve numbers, and we went around the player names. So in a little while, that stripe should set into the figure. If it doesn't, like I said before, you may have to put a little bit of Solvacet on it again. We'll do one more figure here. We'll do one of the running backs. Apply water first and the decal. And you have to make sure that you leave enough room in here for the jersey number also. Have to be conscious of that. So we're applying it like that. Go up a little bit more. And we'll put the Solvacet on. Do the other side. Move around the figure. That's why you use water at first. If you use Solvacet to begin with, you won't be able to slide these around as much. As you can see there, we got that on straight, and then saturate it with the Solvacet on top. And that's what that figure looks like. So I'm going to do the rest of them off camera, and we'll come back and we'll do the sleeve numbers. Okay, so now we have all the shoulder stripes applied to all 22 figures, and now we're going to put on the sleeve stripes, or sleeve numbers. And what you do is you take the numbers like we did before. We're going to cut lengthwise on top and below the row of numbers. To do it under a lamp, just so you won't cut into the number when you're cutting across. You want to be careful. That's one set of sleeve numbers. And we've got one more set here. White numbers are harder to see, so you gotta be right under a lamp. So make sure you don't cut into the numbers. And there's the second set of numbers. Then we're going to take our list and we're going to see which numbers we need, and this is where it really helps. So we'll just take our numbers. The first one I have here is 19, then 20, 21. I'll do those three numbers. So you go to your numbers decals and take your small pair of scissors, and we're going to cut number 19, cut between the numbers. Here's the number 19, here's 20, put them in order again, and we've got 21. Those are the three that I'm going to do on camera, do the rest off camera. The other set here, one for each sleeve, here's 19, put those two together. 19, 20, Okay,
Alright, do just like we did before. Take your finger, put a dab of water on each sleeve with the 19. Slide it off. Thumb. These are some of the hardest to do because they're so small. Take it and apply it there on the sleeve. And just get it in place. Move it around using the water. Alright, you can see it's in place there. Put a little dab of Solvacet on there. And we'll take the other 19. Slide it off. You can see before some of the sleeve stripes didn't set as well as I'd like, so I'm putting another coat of Solvacet on that. Just make sure nothing moves around. And there's the figure there with the number 19. We're going to do number 20 next. Position on the sleeve, move it around in position. Another coat of Solvacet. Water on the other sleeve. And then just work your way through all the figures. I'm putting another coat of Solvacet on the sleeve stripes to make them set real well. If you notice that they're not sitting well, just keep putting the Solvacet on it, and each time you apply the Solvacet, it should make it a little bit better to get where you want it. And the last number here, the 21. Sleeve, move it where you want it. Solvacet on the sleeve stripes again. And on the number, you see the number in place. And you slide that one, this number down a little bit. Just be careful that when they slide around, you have to move them back in place before it sets. And there's the numbers for that. And I'll do the rest off camera, and then we'll tackle the front and back jersey numbers. Okay, so now we have the sleeve numbers applied, and as you can see, the Colts are coming along nicely. The stripes are starting to lay down good. Put another coat of Solvacet on each one of them. And now it's time to do the jersey numbers, front and back. And we'll do exactly the same as we did on the sleeve numbers. We'll take the decal sheet, the numbers, and we'll cut on each side of the row of numbers. We'll do three figures again on camera. And again, with these white numbers, you really got to be careful not to cut into the number. Get right under the lamp, so that you can see what you're doing. There's one row. And we'll cut between each row. And And then we'll use the small scissors to cut between the numbers. All right, good row of numbers. And we look at what numbers we've got to do, and we've got them in order. So the first number is 19, cut between the 18 and 19. 19 on the sponge. And we're gonna do 20 and 21 on camera. 20. All right, look at the other row, same thing, 19, pair it up here with the 19, the 20, and the 21. We'll do these on camera and then do the rest of them off camera. You take the figure, dip your brush in the water. Put just a dab on the front and the back. As you can see, it only takes a few seconds for the decals to be ready to slide off. And you just place it on the figure like that. Do the same thing with the back. These go a lot faster than the sleeve numbers because they're easier to work with. You've got larger numbers, just a lot easier. Main thing on the jersey number is just to try to get them straight. Lined up directly under the name. As you can see there, front and back, and what we'll do is just put a dab of Solvacet on, and that one's done. We'll go to the next one. Dab of water on the front and the back. These go pretty quickly. Just make sure you get them on straight. All right, then we'll put once you get them on straight, put the dab of Solvacet on it. And there's the back and the front. And we'll go to 21. Doing these in a semi-line manner really increases your speed. You got everything laid out the way you need it, and you can just do one right after another, doing all the numbers at the same time. And there's the 21 figure, front and back. Dab of Solvacet. Put a dab right in the center of the number. It'll spread around. That's those three, and we'll do the rest off camera. And after that, we'll tackle the leg stripes. Okay, so now we have all the jersey numbers applied. And the only thing left is the leg stripes. Now, what we're going to do next is we're going to group the figures according to the top figure it is. We'll put all the running backs together. We don't need them to be in numerical order anymore. All the tackles together. This way this will help determine how many leg stripes we need to cut out for each top figure. And we'll make an assembly line out of these. The reason we start from helmet to on top of the helmet all the way down to the bottom is now we can still handle the figures without rubbing off the decals, grab them by the legs, move them around. So we've got five different groups of figures now that we're going to need to decal for leg stripes, and we'll take out the leg stripe decals and we'll do one or two from each group maybe. We got starting here with the wide receivers. Just use the big scissors here and we'll cut down. Looks like we're going to need four.
So we'll just cut down till we get to 4. And here's a major advantage for pre-cuts. It will take forever to cut out each one of these around each decal, to trim around each decal, but we don't have to do that with the pre-cuts. Just cut between the leg stripes. We got 4 for the wide receivers. And we'll go ahead and decal a couple of these on camera. Again, we use water first on each leg. And like always, it just takes a few seconds to be ready to slide off. You can put it on the side of the leg, move it around since we're using water. One done. This goes by so fast with the pre-cuts. This is why I really won't do any anymore unless they're pre-cuts. It just takes too long. You can see both legs there. And we'll go ahead and just supply the solvocet all the way down the leg stripe. Just making sure that it doesn't move, and that should be set. Now, the reason we don't apply paint on the socks before we put the leg stripes, we wait till the very end. As you can see where the leg stripe ends now, we can, when we paint it, we can overlay that bottom of the leg stripe and make it real even with the sock stripe paint. So we wait and do that till the very end. That way we can make it look real even and make it look good. So that's the first one. You can see how quickly we can go through each one of these. Take them, slide them off. Go by really fast. Goes by as fast as you want to go. Move around, get in place. Main thing is just get it on there even and apply a solid set. Put a light on there. Just slide it all the way down. It's 2 done. You can see how quickly we're going. Each one of these. And before you know it, we're going to have all the wide receivers done. And the only thing left to do after this is just paint the sock stripes. And I'm going to paint these with black shoes since they're old school Colts. And then we're going to put a set of, or a coat of gloss glaze on it again to seal in the decals. Make sure we get it on straight and everything. Just gonna let that set and all the leg shots will be done. You can see how quickly we can go. The pre-cuts, you can just go one right after another, not have to worry about trimming. Makes the legs go so much faster. And we have all the wide receivers done. We'll do one more figure from another group. The next in line on the decal sheet is the running backs. And looks like we got 4 of those also. So we just trim out around 4 of them. The sheet, use regular pair of scissors. Here, cut out 4 of the running back figures. You don't even have to cut around them through them like this if you don't want to, but easier to handle 2 at a time. So that's why I'm cutting them out and laying each one on a sponge. So we do the running backs now. See, by the time you put water on the figure, these are ready to come off. Slide off. So the figure, move it around the way you want it.
Here's two. All right, we'll put the Solvacet on it. See what ain't good. Make sure you get a lot of Solvacet on it, especially at the bottom of it, because you don't want any gap in there at the bottom, because you're going to apply paint and the paint will run underneath if you're not careful. All right, still doing the running backs. So much better to use water at first, because it allows you to move it around real easy and get it the way you want it. Because if you put Solvacet on it first, sometimes they'll stick on you. It's better to apply Solvacet after you get it in place. There's number two. We'll go ahead and do these two, and then I'll do the rest off camera. Now, if I remember correctly, these do have sock stripes. So when we get the socks painted, we're going to come back on the camera and we're going to do the sock stripes. And we'll go through the process on doing those. I think they have double line white for the sock stripes for the old school Colts. And these are going by really quickly, really nice. It's like a good looking Colts team now, starting to take shape. And the customers should be very happy with these. Nice and clean. And if you're new to decaling, just be patient. It can be rough at first. I almost quit a few times when I first started out. But stick with it. And it'll become second nature to you. You'll be able to go quickly and get these done the way you want it. And there's the last of the run backs. We're almost halfway through. You can see how long it's taken, just a few minutes. All right, we'll go ahead and do the rest off camera. We'll come back later on after I get the socks painted and we'll do the sock stripes. Okay, so we're moving right along here with the Colts. As you can see here from our plate of Colts, I went ahead and painted all the socks and the shoes, and now everything is done except these Colts have sock stripes and there are two white lines that need to go on the socks. So we're going to put those on and I'm going to show two or three figures of how to do those, and after that we'll come back on after these are all completed. We'll talk a little bit about everything that we've done as far as decaling the team, and hopefully you're going to get something out of this video and able to do it a little bit easier, maybe a little bit faster, learn a couple of new tricks. So we go to our decals. Sock stripes here. These are two white lines. And as in the helmet stripes, this is the same way. We're going to cut across both lines. And this is just going to take a little bit of time on a little bit of practice on how long you make these lines for the socks. Just going to do one here and see how these work. This is Solvacet here, and this bottle cap is full of water like we did before. We're just going to place water around the sock first. Take the decals off with the tweezers, slide off with your thumb. And this will just wrap around the sock just like that. And then we're going to put a good heavy coat of Solvacet on it, which will cause it to lay down. Do the same thing with the next one. See how it wraps around there? Get it on there straight. While the saw was set, and the first figure done there, as you can see. We'll do one more, then we'll do the rest off camera. What I normally do is cut them all out at one time, put them on the sponge. I'm just doing a couple here on camera, just to let you see how it goes. And these colts will be done. If you're just starting out with decals, you just have to be patient. You're gonna mess up on a few figures, but you'll get the hang of it. All right, put the decal on like that. Saw the set on. Just make sure you get it straight. Go back with water on the next other leg. Slide it off. Wrap around. Get as straight as you can and put the saw set on. Make sure it doesn't move after you apply the saw set. And there's number two. And we'll do the rest of the figures and then we'll come back on camera to wrap things up. Okay, we have all of the sock stripes finished. Everything is painted and everything is decaled. We have a complete set of colts here. The last thing we're going to do is put a good coat of gloss glaze on each figure to seal the decals in and give it that shine. I usually just pour a little bit of the glaze into the bottle cap. Take the brush with the thicker bristles here. And like we did before, we just start from head to toe. Work our way down, making sure especially that we coat the decals heavy. This is going to seal them in. It won't rub off during handling. And it'll give it that shiny look. It looks really good when you're playing a game. Make sure you get those leg stripes, sock stripes sealed in good. I put a coat on the entire body so have a good uniform look. Get that sock stripe sealed in really good so you won't have any problem with it rubbing off. Get all the decals sealed in really nice. Just make sure that you get a good even coat. I put a heavy coat on it. Gives it a real good shine. And there's your finished product. We'll do one more. These do take some time, as you're well aware if you've ever decaled a team and you can't really rush it, but there are a lot of things that you can do to speed things up a little bit. And hopefully this video has helped and will help you when you're painting and decaling. Good coat on that sock stripe and the pant stripe. Seal everything in. And you could even come back and put another coat in on top if you like. Sometimes I do that. Extra gloss. There we have it. There's the colts. Completely done from head to toe. And I'd like to thank you for watching this video. You can visit my website BeeNut.com. That's BeeNutt.com. I'm going to post a video on the website. And you can go there for any decals or painted figures that you might need. Have a good day. Thank you for watching.